Our family have lived here for almost 40 years, and whilst engaged on stabilisation of the buildings and site, have done our best to piece together some of its stories. However, there is still much of its interesting history and that of its many and various colourful owners, the actions in which it was involved, that lies uncovered and undiscovered. This lies not only buried in the ground, but also scattered around the country in ancient parchments and documents, some in public records, but no doubt many lying amongst long-forgotten family papers, many no doubt in hard-to-decipher handwritten Latin manuscript. Recently, in 2018, we had a serious water leak. Whilst locating it, under the strict supervision of archaeologists, this medieval cobbling was uncovered in one of the moulding holes, about 1 metre deep. Was this the floor of a building or part of the yard? The presence of many of the pottery shards is unexplained. For example, the high status 14th century, early 15th century shards from a time after the Asthorpes were dead and the Dinham owners did not live here. Any Roman remains would be about 5 metres deep, probably under later medieval buildings. What was William Asthorpe's history? His Inquisition's post-mortem showed he was a bastard without issue, but he was still married to the heiress Margaret Dinham, and they were granted a licence to crenellate, build Hemyock Castle, in 1380. Margaret Hayden, the Hayden heiress, the 12th century owner, must have led a very colourful life. She was married to Sir John Dinham of Hartland and Nutwell. After she was widowed, she moved back to Hemyock, and she married twice more, without the king's permission, for which she seems to have been forgiven, outliving her third husband, Sir Piers Duvedale, who was 20 years her junior. These are just a few examples showing there is still much to uncover.